People know you for what you have done, not for what you plan to do. A hearty good morning to all the dignitaries, one and all, on and off the dais, and to all the student managers. I, Isha Verma, student manager of Balaji Institute of Telecom and Management, welcome you all to the 12th Business Conclave 2017 of BITM. I would be privileged to introduce among us today our guest, Mr. Ketan C. Doshi, sir. Sir is the Managing Director at Paypoint India Network Pvt. Limited. Sir is a postgraduate in Financial Services Management from Mumbai University. Mr. Ketan C. Doshi, sir, has the additional education of Diploma in Investment from Jamna Lal Bajaj Institute of Management Studies. Sir has also an intern chartered accountancy. Mr. Doshi, sir, has been professionally certified by NCFM for equities and FNO and by IRDA. Mr. Doshi, sir, started his career as a back office assistant with Kirti Shah and Company. Sir was later inducted by Chitalia Corporate Services Limited, Merchant Banking Company. Sir also worked as an equity research analyst with Atlas Integrated Finance Limited for a year. After acquiring his master's degree, he founded Win Securities Private Limited in association with Satco Securities. As the Managing Director of Paypoint India, Doshi sir plays a critical role of strategic intervention to transform the potential opportunities into active performances. As a Managing Director, Mr. Doshi sir's mission is to bring convenience to the consumer's doorstep and enabling them to access diversified range of services. Now, I would request Mr. Ketan C. Doshi, sir, to enlighten us with his words of wisdom. Sir, now the dice is all yours. Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. I'm audible. My voice is breaking. Great. Thank you very much, Mr. Krishna Kumar Velluriji, for inviting me here for a lovely morning. Thank you, Mr. Das. He had been relentlessly following up for the session. Students, I am here to understand rather than say anything. I would like to interact with people because young minds have better ideas than what we have. Now, I don't consider myself young now. So, we would like to understand what students think of, what future they see, what they perceive going ahead in their future. I'll address to that also because it is an HR summit, I understand. I'll take you through our company's journey and try to correlate the entire journey with actual life scenario where you can correlate many things. You will understand the process, how a business is and what business needs are and how you can be part of the business as a business owner. We are at 70th year of independence, and our nation is going through a radical change, and I feel it is the time where India should show that, boss, we are also technologically very superior. We are going to be powerful in next 5-7 years. Our GDP growth is going to be one of the best in the world, and we have best of the investors coming to India, and the entire future relies on this crowd, young people like you, which are going to be the major contribution or a contributor to this growth. So I would like to know from the entire crowd how many people are, or how many people sitting here are looking to get into new ventures or businesses over a period of time. Say around 20%. Wow. That's all. Can you again raise the hand? Wow. Great, great. So, but still it is very low. What I would do is I will take you through our company's journey, and if I can convert some more, I mean, from 20, if I can make it to 30, it would be great, because my HR friend or my director sitting here, they are concerned what is the placement, how do we place my students. But I would rather say you should be an enabler to place someone rather than getting placed. That is the thing which we should rather gun for, and not gunning for a mediocre thing like where I will get placed. Think differently, think big. Hire some people, hire hundreds of people, and you can do it. I can assure you can do it. I'll take you through a brief presentation, because my brief has already been given by the respected lady. Still, I'll again redo it. I've done my master's in financial services. I've done post-graduation in investments. I'm from a regular family. My dad was working at bank, and we never had any family businesses. I'm a first generation entrepreneur, and right from my college days, I used to think that I have to do something on my own. And my dad was pushing me, hey boss, bank ka form bhar de, PO officer ka recruitment aa raha hai. Every day the same scenario. I don't know how many people have, anyone who has done that probation officer form, I'm sure many guys have done it. Wow. Even I have done many times. So this is the kind of background where I am coming from. My dad, whenever we go to some party or some marriage or some function, I was doing my master's, he used to tell his friend, mere bete ke liye koi job don't le. Please help him. I want him to be settled. He's studying. I don't know what he's going to do in his life. He's not focused. So this is the background where I'm coming from. And I'm sure many, many people are undergoing similar pains at their home front. Peer group pressure, family pressure, your mom will say ki beta ek government job karega to shaadi ho jayegi, achhi ladki milegi. New pressure. Your sasural or so-called, prospective father-in-law will say, if you are working in a bank or an MNC, then I'll give you my daughter. Am I right? Really? Wow. So I'll take you through my journey, how it happened, what happened. We started in 2007. This is a 10-year-old journey, and it has been wonderful. Very many ups and downs in the company. Through this process, we learned many things, which if I could download here, it would be wonderful. We started in 2007. The vision was to be the fast-moving consumer services company in the country. See, my marketing team has given me a mandate to sell the company's product. So that is what I am doing right now. Yeah, that is also part of my mission. So that is what I am covering. But in the process, I will take you through the journey, and if I can push you through to become an entrepreneur, I would love to do it. So there were many companies in the country doing fast-moving consumer goods. You might have seen now the latest, which is the latest fast-moving consumer goods company in the country? Do you know? Yeah, great. Patanjali. So that is doing fast-moving consumer goods. So we have Hindustan Lever, we have Patanjali, we have Nestle, many companies. ITC. because you guys are searching FMCG where to get placed, so you know all the names right now. Am I right? So, sorry. So, there were no companies delivering fast-moving consumer services. So, we thought that, boss, let's have a single platform where all the services can be delivered. Services can be any service which is in an organized fashion. Why that came up? Because I was running a company, a financial services company, because I am from a financial services background. In 2007, we had lease lines, ISDN lines, phone lines, 3-4 companies mobile. Every day we used to go and stand in a queue to make a payment. So for MTNL, one line, BSNL, one line, Reliance, one line, Reliance Energy, third line, fourth line, Tata Docomo, fifth line, local cable operator, because that time the IT infrastructure was not sturdy. If one pipe is down, one internet connectivity is down, we have to switch to other, we have to switch to third. I'm sure many people who have undergone, they know it, how it happens. So we thought that there needs to be a single window where all the bill payments can be done. So we created a platform. Eventually, while creating a platform, we realized that there are many other services which can be ported on the single platform, which was recharges, DTH. So eventually, I'll come to many other services which we added. So this is how, the pain area was the origination of an idea. My pain of standing in a queue. Here there is Maharashtra State Electricity Board. Right. If you go right now, we are in a digital age. You go and make a payment at MSCB counter, you will have to stand at least 20 minutes. Or maybe more. I don't know. So if we can address to a problem area which we are facing on a daily basis, definitely there is a business case. And we should be open to understanding this on a regular basis. You are traveling, you are moving across, you have friends. So you are undergoing many processes in a day, and there are problem areas. If we can pick up one problem area and resolve it, that would be, it is a new business idea. But think big, a small scale resolution will not suffice. In this age, we have to think very big. So let's move ahead. We wanted to bring convenience to the consumer's doorstep. We built a platform which connected this kind of four verticals, recharges. We have financial services. This Jandan Yojana, which is going on in the country, we are running it at the ground level. So what we do is, we create retail touch points which are digitally connected across the country, and a consumer can walk into this digitally connected touch point and do a transactions which are of recharges, financial services, utilities and bookings. So these are the kind of digital touch points what we have. These were the first set of retailers which we signed up. We have 45,000 retail touch points across the country. May it be J&K, Lakshadweep, Goa, everywhere, right in Pune also. These are the kind of queues which used to be there, and then we resolved it with zero queue. So we addressed a problem area. Major presence are in rural locations where there is more pain, and metros, say around 25% of the rollout is there. So what we do is, when a problem is addressed through a new solution, there needs to be lots of customer education. Now, I am connecting with your role going ahead. There is lots of customer education which is required. If I am downloading a wallet, so there is constant marketing. The medium can be different. It can be digital or an offline medium. There needs to be a constant marketing in terms of how the wallet can be used, how a product can be used, how on the ground level the product can be rolled out. that needs to be, it is a constant process. So any new product addition, your marketing, your sales will come in place. Here, your creativity comes in place, how efficiently you can deliver a product, how efficiently you can market it, how creatively you can think. Because this is a major area where India is moving currently. Currently, I don't know how many, most of the people think here that businesses are run by online marketing. And that is done by a techie. Am I right? So where is the role of a techie, boss? It is the creativity of your mind. If it is the creativity of your marketing people who gives a campaign and the techie guys only code it, relay it. The major business which is going to happen is digital. Major marketing push is going to be digital. But the guy sitting behind who is creating this marketing push is a marketing or a sales guy. It is the sales guy's mind which thinks how I can introduce this product. The marketing guy thinks how I can push it. So new areas where everyone needs to focus, young students like you needs to be focused, is how a customer is coming on board. It can be through a rural campaign. It can be through an online platform. So this is the area I think one should focus on, because most of them have a confusion whether it is a tech guy or a marketing guy. Most of the tech companies hire marketing people to run the campaign. All of them, rather not most, all of them hire marketing or sales guy to run this campaign. None of the campaigns are run by technology guys. Am I clear? So how we started? I started, so now again, people who want to get into business, which is my push area at this moment, rather than going to some company and floating a CV. Create a good team, very healthy, very good team whom you can rely on. You have trust, complete trust, without any hesitation. You can give some data to him, or give money or take money from him. So you need a good team with variety of exposure. Means the team needs to be, supposing if let's take an example of cricket, if I have 10 Sachin Tendulkars in the team, will it win? Right? You need a bowler, you need a batsman, you need a wicket keeper. So that's how, if you want to build a team, if a business is built, it needs sales, it needs marketing, it needs finance, it needs HR, it needs technology, it needs legal. So you need to have, you need to build a team which is vibrant. Vibrant means once you are getting in business, you need to forecast, or you need to understand what are the needs of the business. Whether I need a marketing guy, how key is the marketing role in that business? Whether I need an HR guy, because I'm going to hire 1,000 people, I need at least 5 guys who are from HR side. So I need a partner who's going to take care of the HR side. Whether I need a finance guy, because finance is going to be key in the portfolio. Without funds, it will not work. So we need to have variety of people on the team. That will take you ahead very fast, and it will take care of many problems which are going to come ahead in your life. It may look very easy that boss, ye website dal diya, maine aggregation kar diya product ka, it okay. Matlab bahut hi zabardast idea hai. Hum online marketing karenge, Facebook karenge, WhatsApp karenge, doston ko bolenge, and we are going to be live. Am I right? Most of them think that way. But when you go to the market, this will kickstart your business within your vicinity, but that is limited. If there is no size, there is no operational benefit. If there is no operational edge, the other guys who are bigger, larger, will just come and kill your business. So what challenges currently we are facing is, in business, first, the team. Team, retention of team is very key. Ownership is very key. For me, if I have to hire someone, I will look for someone who is going to be a complete owner, ownership mindset. He doesn't think that, boss, this is not my company. For me, his department, he is the owner. If he is not an owner, he is not in my company. So most of them think that it is a 10 to 6 job. I am getting well paid. I have this degree and my background is this, and I am getting so much businesses for the company. But that is not the company's need. Company may hire a guy who is from a finance background, heading technology, but having complete knowledge, understanding, and ownership of the department. It is possible and it is happening at this moment. People are doing cross department jobs. So one of the need is ownership. We need a complete ownership of your portfolio. If I am hiring, I would like to hire someone who has a complete ownership. So ownership can again lead you to a business opportunity. You yourself, you've run a department as an owner. Now you know how you can run it as an owner. I mean, you can start your own business. We need good friends, good mentors. In your career, if you want to move ahead, create a good circle, means your peer group should be really vibrant. Good, faithful means you can talk to your friends when in need, when in stress, personally, professionally. You have you are undergoing some professional problem, or you are undergoing some problem in the business. You need to have a good peer group, good friends, right from, and you need to have variety of group. You can have chartered accountants, you can have finance guy, you can have marketing guy, you can have legal guy, you can have, matlab, hum bolte hai na ki ye banda jugadu hai, kuch bhi kar sakta hai, because he has understanding, he has connectivity across the, I mean, he has 360 degree understanding of the market because of his circle. So you need to have very good people around you to move ahead. You need to have very good mentors. Today, I mean, most of the time I used to sit in the corner of that hall and enjoy, but today, when I was in college, I never used to interact with my professors regularly. And it was like just killing time. I used to score good, but that's all. Scoring was the only purpose and moving ahead. Now I realize, and now I have reinitiated. Last few years, I am in regular touch with my old professors, my old teams, my old gurus. You need to have very good mentors in your life. Because you may not realize, eventually, every point of time we need mentors, we need gurus. I don't know how many have gurus, but too early to have gurus. Where you can sit and make them understand what is that you need, what is that you want, where you are stuck. It looks very, I mean, at this age you will not feel comfortable listening to it, but too early. But still I am pushing it, that you need to have someone whom where you can go and talk and tell them that, boss, this is what I think, whether it is right. This guru will help you in validating the entire piece. You should have complete faith on it. Because you may decide, I may decide, boss, main to US hi jaane wala hu. I want to go to US. I don't know anything else. My focus is US. Very good. Financially looks good. But Guru may validate it. Why you want to go to US? Is there any purpose of going to US? Is there any agenda in your life? Why you want to go to US? Whether you want to get into technology, whether you want to go to finance in US? That Guru is going to validate. Unless and until you have someone whom you can rely on, whom you can speak to and understand, make him understand what you want, I think we may take a wrong step. As a youngster, we may take a wrong step, we can move in a wrong direction and finally end up in doing something which was not worth it. So Guru can streamline your thought process, which is very much needed, which we don't have it at this moment. Today the Guru is, you know what? Google search. Anything you want, just Google it. Am I right? Most of the things are Google search. In this scenario, what to do? Google search. That this is not going to happen, yeah, boss. This is not going to work. So, I don't know, many people are not interested in business, but I would like to put something here for businesses. It's a chakra view. Means, there is a technology guy who wants to build a technology. There is a sales guy who wants to do a sale. And there is a buyer. Now, if you go to a buyer, the buyer will ask you, where is your sale? If you go to seller, where is your product? And if you want to go to, tell your technology guy, this is the platform I want to build, he will say, okay, what is the process you want? Give me buyer's process, seller's process. So in the entire process, the entire project gets delayed. Most of the time, if it is a bigger project, breaking this chakra view takes time. So there is a lead time to break this chakra view or this circle. When you get into something new, just assume that at least you are going to spend, if it is a small kickstart operation, 100 days, and if it is a large operation, at least 3 years, that is 1,000 days. Unless and until you have a view that you can sustain till 100 days or 1,000 days, this is not going to take you anywhere. You will break down, you will fight, what you will do is generally how it kickstarts. I have a friend, yaar mere ko ye karna hai. I have another friend, can you get me some finances? We want to do this. So three partners, three idiots. They come together, then the things do not kickstart well. Within 100 days, they start fighting and the financier says, boss, my dad is saying I am not putting additional money. This generally happens. And level two, the money is again arranged from a fourth partner. So this goes on, goes on, goes on. So unless and until your visibility is of 100 years, you have capex, patience, majorly patience. If you have a patience of 100 years, 100 days, it will not work. Friends, it took 3 years for us to crack this chakra. We had 100 people, team, sitting in the office doing nothing. Building technology which we don't know whether it will be used or not. 3 years, that is 1,000 days. No business. 150, 120 people sitting in the office. So if I would have lost patience, I would have not been here. So this is what it is. This is what it is. If you are getting into some new business, take care of this chakra view. And I am insisting you just push yourself hard towards business rather than focusing. I know today you are thinking, "Yar, boss, mere ko naukri kaam milega, wo bata yaar. Why are you wasting my time?" I would rather push, rather switch your focus. India is growing fast. There are multiple opportunities. You are going to make really very big money if you get into business. So I will take you through what we are going through in India. I mean, the core focus area why I'm here. We belong to financial technology. We belong to fintech. I don't know how many people know what is fintech, or they've heard about fintech. I don't know. Can you just raise the hand? Anyone who knows fintech? Very good. So hardly anything. So it is financial technology. All financial services are getting technologically enabled. Friends, today in India, the biggest industry and biggest growth is coming on fintech side. And if you are away from it, you are away from the market. And if you are away from the market, the possibility of market absorbing you or you doing something new in the industry is very low. Why? Today, Jandan is happening in the country. Jandan, I'm sure everyone is aware of what is happening in the Jandan Yojana. It has done Guinness Book of Records. Was highest number of bank accounts were pushed and were opened during this period, during Modiji's push on Jandan. Highest number of bank accounts. India, after 70 years, not 70 rather, before this 1 year, I mean 69 years, we could not open bank accounts of 40% Indians, 40-45% Indians did not, only had bank accounts. 55% of the Indians did not had bank accounts. So if you don't have a bank account, I don't have any other financial services. I don't have insurance. I don't have mutual fund. I don't have loans. I have not never taken loans from a formal institution. So today there are five things happening in the country. Jandan, digital revolution is happening because of mobile. Aadhaar is now a universal KYC, because previously wherever we used to have KYC, hum log xerox nikal ke KYC submit karte the bank mein, LIC office mein, wherever you go, there were KYCs required. Xeroxes of KYC. Today, Aadhaar is there. So digital KYC is instant. GST is coming. Now, GST is going to change the entire scenario in the country. Everything is coming. Everything is getting organized. No one had bank account. Now, they have a bank account. People have started paying GST. If they don't have GST, people avoid doing business. I don't know, GST, I'm sure people are aware of it here on the GST front. So people have started organizing themselves. Now every invoice is going to be getting, are going to be uploaded on the central system of government. So digital trail is available. Person having zero digital trail have opened bank account. They are submitting their returns on a monthly basis. Jandan Yojana going on, Aadhaar going on, digital happening. New two things are coming up, small banks and payments bank. Boss, these are the scenario, or these are the areas where currently the focus of government is. India generally works as a reg tech. I don't know how many people understand reg tech. Reg tech is regulatory technology. All the businesses in India currently are working on regulatory tech. Because any change in the regulation, new technology evolved, new process flows are evolving. So boss, this reg tech is going to explode in next one and a half year. Major area where our entire generation, how many finance guys are there? They feel, yeah, great. So major areas are opening up in terms of small bank and payment bank. Now, if people think bank means finance. Finance guys are only eligible. Boss, this is not it. Marketing guys are required to sell the bank. Finance ke paas to tabhi jayega jab koi product bikega. Jab rollout hi nahi kar payega, to फाइनेंस का गाय करेगा क्या बैठ के. सो दिस आर द मेजर एरियाज वेयर ग्रोथ इज गोइंग टू हैपन. व्हाट इज द इमर्जिंग लैंडस्केप इन कंट्री बिकॉज ऑफ दिस टुडे, बिकॉज ऑफ डीमोनेटाइजेशन, बिकॉज ऑफ जनधन योजना, इज टू मच लिक्विडिटी इन द सिस्टम. लिक्विडिटी इन टर्म्स ऑफ एवरीथिंग विच वॉज लाइंग इन तिजोरी और मम्मी के पोटली में रखा था या जो भी है, वेर एवर इट वॉज लाइंग, इट इज कम इन द बैंक अकाउंट. सो देर इज ह्यूज लिक्विडिटी इन द बैंकिंग सिस्टम. न्यू कस्टमर्स आर फ्लॉकिंग बैंक टू पार्क मनी. लेंडर्स हैव एक्सेस लिक्विडिटी. बिकॉज लेंडर्स हैव एक्सेस लिक्विडिटी, दे आर लेंडर्स स्काउटिंग फॉर न्यू क्लाइंट्स, न्यू बिजनेसेस. सो अपॉर्चुनिटीज फॉर एन SME और एन MSME टू बोरो बिकम्स बेटर बिकॉज लेंडर्स आर विलिंग टू लेंड यू एट अ चीपर रेट एंड दे आर लुकिंग एग्रेसिवली टू लेंड एंड रेट्स आर गोइंग टू बी रियली लो इवेंचुअली. मेजर थ्रस्ट एरिया इन फिनटेक इज हाउसिंग फाइनेंस कंपनीज आर ग्रोइंग. आई डोंट नो हाउ मेनी पीपल आर अवेयर, लास्ट टू ईयर्स देर वी हैव सीन मल्टीपल हाउसिंग फाइनेंस कंपनीज पेनेट्रेटिंग द मार्केट. यू माइट हैव हर्ड इंडिया बुल्स, इंडिया इन्फोलाइन, देन फोर्टिस फाइनेंशियल, रेलिगेयर टेक, रेलिगेयर. सो यू माइट हैव हर्ड मेनी फाइनेंस कंपनीज कमिंग इन टू द मार्केट. नाउ वॉट दिस हाउसिंग फाइनेंस कंपनीज डू इज दे बोरो फ्रॉम द बैंक्स एंड लेंड इट अहेड. And there is a slight rate differential, but they are very aggressive. So, housing finance companies, more than 200 large housing finance companies have registered in India with a huge capital base. These are the areas where each and every student of here should focus on for their future. Because this is going to lead the country in next wave. That is called Pradhan Mantri Nivas Yojana. Right? Awas Yojana. Sorry. Awas Yojana. And there is something called low cost housing, which is coming up. So all these housing finance companies are going to fund there. Now, point I am trying to drive is, these housing finance companies will need people to market. Will need people in operations, will need people, because these are all technology driven companies, will need people in technology and will need people in finance. So these are the areas which should be focused for our next, these are new age companies which are going to grow. Again, mutual funds are going to be very big. Because there is excess liquidity, there are people now, most of the people are getting educated. Most of the students have started doing SIPs. I don't know, many students I've seen, they are doing SIPs from 12, 13. After 18 standard, all their pocket money is put in SIPs. Have you seen this thing? Systematic investment plans? Great. So this is going to be a very big industry because fund is coming in. Systematic investment plan means this fund is going to get invested in equity market or new businesses, and new businesses have again opportunity to borrow or get funded from some mutual fund or VC or PE. Selling of mutual fund is going to be a very big market. Managing mutual fund is going to be a very big market. Managing funds as a portfolio manager is going to be a very big market. So investment related activity is going to boom in next 2 years. It has already boomed. We are already in that phase. Under penetrated market like rural locations, small towns, semi-towns, there are people looking to invest, looking to raise funds, but they don't have people who solicit them or go them and meet them. So these are the areas where superior yields are going to come, and companies like housing finance companies, mutual funds, or any other financial services companies, they are looking to explore this market. Now you can be either one enabler by creating a network there as a businessman and enable these companies to capture that customer, or you can actually go to the company and tell them, "Boss, this is the area I am ready to work, and this area is right for this product, and I am here to acquire so many customers." And whether your portfolio is marketing, finance, or HR, doesn't mean. Company needs, boss, penetration in that market. So you need to pitch to the companies that, "Boss, we are capable, or you are capable of rolling out that service in this underpenetrated market." So our point of view in terms of manpower or industry, how it is going to happen, all financial institutions, which are the major recruiters in the country, financial institutions, banks, broking houses, insurance, what else? Pardon? AMCs, mutual funds. So these are NBFCs, private banks, digital payments, mobile wallets. These are the major recruiters in the market. They used to be a major recruiters in the market. Now what is happening? Most of the financial institutions are going digital. Most of them. So the focus will change from physical channels to digital channels. What does it mean for us? It means manpower will be less required on physical mode. Maybe people, currently they are recruiting 1,000 people as foot on street. It may come down to say 600 people. So that is a threat. So same way, banks, traditional banks, if you see public sector banks, your traditional banks, typically their branch footfall is going to decrease drastically. So if you are filling that PO officer form, it is most likely that next 6 months you will stop seeing recruitment process of this PSU bank. Public sector banks will reduce their physical presence. There will be no recruitment. Some private banks, I would rather say Axis and ICICI, they are always ahead in terms of technology. These banks will continue, but they may not add many people on the road. So all banking transactions are going digital. I'm sure everyone has a banking app on their mobile to transact. So people are not going to bank. So recruitment process in the entire banking will lose. Same way mutual funds, digital process will happen. Same way your lending. I don't know how many people know that lending has started online. Instant. Do you know this? You know how it happens? Supposing you want to borrow to make your school college fees. You can just put a request that I want to borrow 10,000 rupees for whatever, blah, blah, blah. The systems will check your Facebook, your Twitter, your LinkedIn, and entire digital trail will be checked. If you have a CIBIL record, they will check your CIBIL record, and within 10 minutes, the loan will be offered to you. And if you confirm within 1 hour, the fund is in your account. That is what is happening in the world. The point which I am trying to drive is all financial institutions are going to digital formats. So now what we can do? Either come out of the system of financial institutions or ride on it. What we can do is rather ride on it, find out what is happening in the country, what is happening in the world, be part of it, and make your future out of it. Every time there is a change, there is new opportunity. When computers came in India, people thought ki sab log bekar ho jayenge. But what happened? India became a superpower in software. If you see, if you don't change, classic example, Nokia is out of the market. So ride what is required, ride what is the need of the hour. Stronger distribution network is required, that is fine. Simplified, all the products will become very simple to understand. There will be no complex product. If you want to massify, there is likely that all complex products will come out of the market. It will be easy to understand because it will be digital. It will be rolled out on a mass level. If a product is rolled out on a mass level, product has to be easy to understand. 100 rupiya bhara, itna milega. 500 rupiya bhara, itna milega. 5000 bhara, aap mar gaye to 5 lakh milega. Simple. Nothing else. Today it is very complex. 5 lakh bhara, 2000 rupiya aapka investment ho gaya, 3000 isme ho gaya, ye ho gaya. So it is very complex currently. But what will happen is products are going to be simpler, simple to understand. It can be rolled out digital. What is going to happen in terms of financial services? It will become a commodity. Bank accounts were opened by only premium customers who have PAN card, KYC. Eventually, you have seen bank accounts have become commodity. All financial services are going to be a commodity. Insurance will be bought in 5 minutes. Loans will be available in 10 minutes. Mutual funds can be done real time. Why to waste time? Abhi chahiye. Right now I can buy a mutual fund. Stocks is available on a real-time basis. So all financial services are going to become commodity. The rollout of financial services is only 5 to 7% in India. Apart from bank is not a financial services. If you say insurance, 5 to 7%, mutual funds, demat accounts, 5 to 7%, not above it. So there is a huge opportunity. This 7% is going to 20%. It will go to 20% in next 7-10 years. It is a huge opportunity. How to ride this opportunity? You are better to understand because you are youngsters. You know how we can tweak the model, how it can happen. You know the ground level better. Why don't you apply your creativity and find out a model to roll out this kind of services, which can be a multi-bagger. Because 7% it took 70 years, and in 10 years it is going to add 13%. It's a multi-bagger opportunity, multi-billionaire opportunity. So what I would insist is focus in these areas. The sectoral trend, I have already given you traditional bank vis-a-vis private banks. Opportunities have opened up in two areas, small banks and private banks, payments bank. I don't know how many people track small bank and private banks, payment bank. Do you guys know what is happening on the small bank front and payments bank front? So that is a very big opportunity for, your growth, because these banks are going to be aggressive. If you have an opportunity to get into these banks, they can change your maybe after 5 years, you will be veteran among the industry for payments or small bank. So these are huge opportunities because these are small, aggressive banks working locally, and they are more led by digital initiatives. And large software companies, I'm sure you, everyone has seen it. Large software companies may undergo a major slowdown. And new software companies with cutting edge new tech are going to grow. I mean, there is a huge possibility for everyone to get into it. You need not be a software or a techie. All software companies have finance guys inside it. They have management people. They have HR. They have marketing. They have complete team. So if we focus on this kind of small niche growing areas, if you can identify, boss, it is a very big opportunity. Very big opportunity. You can see the trend. Microsoft and IBM used to rule the world. Today it is Facebook, today it is WhatsApp. Different kind of companies are growing. If we can get into it, it is going to be a very big opportunity for us. IC, Infosys, Wipro, or whatever big companies, large companies, some companies will change, but some companies may not change. And the possibility of getting into it or making your future into it will be really difficult. Because the growth, if the companies do not grow, how you will grow? And the companies which are growing, which are small, which will not give you a tag of Infosys or TCS, but a small company which is growing at 100, 200, 300%, your future definitely is going to be correlated with the company's growth. BPOs, again, I see a major problem area. This is going to be replaced by robots. It's a big dying business means my point of view. BPOs are going to be obsolete in some time because everything is getting automized. Robots are taking place. I'm sure any technology guys, do you know what is bots? Good, great. So your other teammates know it? Because if you know bots and you are working on bots, I'm sure you are going to replace the people who are going to be an operation side. So it is a threat for people who are going to be on the support side. So I would say, please understand this bots which is coming up, which is going to take over the entire world in next, say, 1 year. After 1 year, you will see many human processes done by machines, and there will be no support team required. Have you used Siri? I was just asking someone, have you used, how many have iPhones? Great. So you have used that assistant Siri. How is it? How is the experience? It is actually answering your queries? So that is what is called bots. It is a robot. This robot can replace human where there are standard processes. So I can check with robot either by chatting or by over the phone. I can ask ICICI Bank robot that whether my fund is credited or not. It will respond. So all these BPOs and KPOs will get replaced by robots. It is a very big threat. Again, a very big opportunity for people who can build robots, who can understand how the robot is to be built. Robot is a word, there is no machine. It is a virtual robot. It is a digital whatever. There is no machine behind it. It is coding. So again, new things which are coming up is artificial intelligence and BIs. This is also going to take over the entire country because AI can reduce many human processes, and business intelligence can take away many RICO or reconciliation processes or MIS processes. But there's a huge opportunity in this segment because new segments are going to get digitized if we can get into artificial intelligence or business intelligence. Transport also is going to take a very big change. Boss, I don't know, all of them are reading driverless cars. Yeah, this is going to happen eventually. Kab to hoga? Maybe 1 year, 2 years down the line. So if I have a transport company and there is a driverless driver, means boss, the entire business is gone. The guys who are driving, they're out of the business. And I have, say, transport, public utility, say, aapka Pune, means, Pune, some transport company will be there who is doing, in our Bombay, it is BEST buses, who are plying local buses. If the local bus is driverless, and if there is no conductor, just tap in, tap out, is it doable? Easily doable. The entire industry is going to see a sea change. No driver, no bus. No bus, no conductor. Even no bus is going to come. If Narendra Modi and thanks to Jio, if Jio manages to roll out this low-cost internet bandwidth across the country, why I should go to office? I don't need to go to office. I can do that work from my home. I have video camera to do my meetings. I have computer to process the entire data. And only meetings, if external meetings are required, I'll step out, boss. I don't need offices. So if I don't need office, transport is going to take a hit. I don't need public transport. I don't need vehicles. So that also can happen, but things are moving. So opportunities. If we see opportunity, boss, whatever. Friends, wherever there is an unorganized way of dealing a product or service, this is going to get organized. Biggest opportunity is India has high unorganized sector. It can be, I have cited one thing, idli wala. You know how it operates? Can someone tell me? You know how it is happening in the country? I don't know, I know metros actually, how it is happening. There is only one idli wala making that idli and distributing it to the entire centers. There is a van moving across the city. Saab, 50 idli bhejo, wo hotel mein pahunch jayega. There is no guy making it individually. This is what is happening in Mumbai. And that guy has organized the unorganized idli walas who was standing on road with that idli chutney. That guy is organized, he is making 2 lakh idlis a day. Can you imagine? Right? That is the size if you organize a product. There are one more thing, momos now, fresh thing. Momos are also made in a single factory. Most of the cases, they are not made, they are centralized. I don't know, many people will know it. So they are. What is happening? Everything is getting organized. People are looking at size and efficiency. If you see Flipkart, what they have done is they have organized the entire retail industry. They have bring it to on a, they have bought it to a single platform. That platform is efficient. it reduces the cost of creating a you know, shop or a display. Whatever money is saved, that Flipkart makes. Same way, if you see Make My Trip, they've organized the entire piece of traveling. Most of us use Make My Trip or Ibibo or whatever. Ola is again a very big example where unorganized sector was there few years before. We used to, matlab wo taxi milega, nahi milega, whether I can go there, take a driver. It was a huge hassle. Ola has organized the entire taxi wallahs. Now in India, there are multiple opportunities to organize ourselves. If you see opportunities where there is huge organization, I mean, organized pieces required is, I don't know, agriculture, highly unorganized. So no one is talking about agriculture, it is not a fancy thing. Who kon kheti wadi karega? But highly unorganized. Highly unorganized, highly inefficient. Can someone think of it? It is not a fancy thing, but it will become, when you, once you make it big, na, boss, people will give you, call you for that interview, ke boss, this guy has organized the entire agri segment. There are many processes in the entire agri segment, which are highly inefficient, unorganized, and because of that we are suffering. India is said to be an agri-economy. Agri-economy, what we are doing, nothing. All farmers are dying. Why? Because the land bank of a farmer is small. There are no tools used. There is no organized guy who is supporting them. Can we do it? I'm sure all these youngsters can do it. You have to think differently. Don't go by the what is happening in the industry. You have to create a new industry. Get into a new industry. It will not happen. I mean, when someone started Ola, it was not a fancy thing. Now everyone knows Ola, right? When Bhavish started, it was, अरे उनका dad बोलते होंगे, अरे क्या taxi का कुछ तो भाड़े पे चला रहा है. Correct. My dad used to say, वो bill payment कर रहा है, एक-एक रुपया कमा रहा है, क्या कर रहा है मालूम नहीं. So there is huge opportunity in organizing an unorganized segment. You guys, always you are out, you know, you see many things. Why don't you identify a thing and start organizing it? Meals, there are canteens. I don't know, canteens are now becoming centralized. Some meal guy is making 2,000, 5,000 meals and supplying 500 here, 500 here, 1,000 there. That is how it is getting organized. And they are making good money. Sector digitization, I already briefed you about what is happening in bots, BI, artificial intelligence. One more segment which is going to be very big is digital security. Since everything is going digital, digital security is going to be a very big market. Because if I digitize something, it has to be secured. If it is not secured, likely that I'll incur a huge loss. So most of the companies are spending huge money on security layers. So this is the areas to focus on rather than going traditionally, bank ka form bharna band kar do, kuch nahi hone wala. Bank, most of them aspire. There are two aspirations in the country I have seen. One set of people, they will say, US jana hai boss. So why? I don't know. US jana hai. My cousin, my very close cousin, whenever, I mean, he comes to Bombay, he stays in Jaipur, comes to Bombay, like, kyun aaya Bombay? Oh, US ka visa lagya. That's all. Well, what do you want to do in US? I don't know. I want to go to US. That's all. There is no purpose in life. He doesn't know what to do. First time rejected because he doesn't know what to do there. He asked the guy sitting on the other side, asked him, kya karega? US jayega. So, tu bhi ja. Ghar pe ja. So, second time. Same, USI. Most of the people in India, sir. Not India, I mean many people I've seen. Now things have changed, but people want to go to US, that's all. But what they want to do there, it is good to go to US, but you should have a purpose. Whether you want to do something big in technology, whether you want to do good in banking, whether you have any business model which can be run globally, some clarity. There has to be some clarity. Just going, sitting there, useless. Waste of life. I don't know, many people might be aspiring here also, going US, but I'm sorry. This is not what I want. This is, I don't think this is the future. Other people's bank ka form bharna hai, humko ek bank mein job, nokri chahiye. This is what is happening, this we have seen. This is very sad affair, boss. And currently the scenario in US also is very difficult. Most likely that you will not end up getting there. And after 2-3 years of persuasion going to US, you will break down and you will end up doing a mediocre thing in India, which will be frustrating you throughout your life. That is the end of your life. Same way, banks, I am telling you, bank is getting digitized. Opportunities are in banks are going to be very low. There are new set of banks coming, which are going to be digital banks, so-called digital banks, which are payments bank and small banks. The entire focus area of the placement cell here should be capturing payments bank and small bank and housing finance companies. These are going to drive the entire growth. And there is a need here. What I like, if I want to hire someone as a skill set, or someone like me, if he wants to hire or want to come, want to bring someone on board, I would look at few things in a person. How passionate he is about his work, about his mission, about his vision. Unless and until I see that spark or passion in that person, I will never hire them. Never. I will hire them for a back office operation. That is fine. That is I don't need someone to drive my business. If the guy has a passion, I would love to have him on board. He need not be the specialist of that area where I want to hire. But I know if he has a passion, he is going to drive it. Wo apna kaam kar lega. He will not think. Consistency. Again, there is a major problem in terms of consistency in this new generation. Means today I get into one job or one business or one product. After a few months I will get tired. I move on to second one. After a few days again I am tired or I'm bored of this monotonous work and I will move on to some third job. At the age of 30, he or she might have switched at least 5 jobs. After that what? After that, no big companies, after 32, no big companies will hire you because they don't see consistency, clarity of thought in your mind. If you are clear that this is not my cup of tea, why did you enter it? No, sir, because I wanted a job. My family was in problem. This is a standard thing. Every family is in problem. Our family was also in problem. But you should have selected a piece where you want to get in. You are a finance guy and you have applied for a marketing job, which you don't want to do, but it's a stopgap requirement. This is going to kill your career. So if you are consistent, people are ready to back you, companies are giving a real good growth, new age companies, the growth is very high, but consistency, passion, and focus approach is required. If you keep on switching jobs, keep on switching businesses, keep on switching your thought process, this is going to derail your life eventually, and you will end up nowhere. So if there's a guy who has a passion, ye karna hi hai, karega hi, that's all, boss. That's all we want. Last thing. Someone, madam was sitting here asking me, ki, sir, where is the opportunity? Sales, marketing, finance, technology, HR. Now, I was not clear what to say, but if you see across the globe and in India, everything has become collaborative. No one person can deliver entirety. It is a team effort. You guys are organizing this programs. Do you think one person can handle it? One can lead it, but it is not a one man's job. So world is moving towards pehle wo system tha banne ke hisab se wo chalta tha. एक सेट होगा वही अपना ड्राइव करेगा बाकी जो बंदे नीचे हैं वो उसको फॉलो करेंगे बट दैट इज एंडिंग बिकॉज द स्केल ऑफ ऑपरेशन इज लिमिटेड नाउ वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट स्केल इन केस ऑफ स्केल इट इज अ कोलैबोरेटिव एफर्ट माय आई विल टेल यू माय टीम माय सेल्स गाय थिंक्स दैट बॉस ही इज रनिंग द कंपनी बिकॉज ही इज गेटिंग रेवेन्यू एंड ही इज earning bread and butter for the company. My HR guy thinks that, boss, because I am here and managing people, this company is working. My finance guy thinks that, boss, because I am getting them funds, this company is operational, and sales guy is getting their salary, or HR ka to kuch kaam hi nahi hai, paisa to main deta hu. Tech. Now comes the tech guy. He comes in shorts, t-shirt, doesn't come sometime, works from home. Very good. He thinks that because I have built this platform, this show is going on. If I switch off the platform, show will go off. This is what is happening. But eventually, what is happening is it is a collaborative movement. World is moving towards collaboration. There is space for all streams. You have to be master in that stream. You have to be focused. If you know that stream well, it can be a niche area, small area, but master it. There is nothing better than me in this stream. No one can stop you. There is requirement in all arena. Human resources, marketing, sales, finance, tech, everywhere there is expansion. India is moving at a higher growth rate, so you will be absorbed, but you will be absorbed or you can start on your own, as I say, anything, but you have to be master in it. If you are not master, that means you are going to be replaced by a robot, because a standard process is going to be run by a robot. If you are master, no one can replace you. You will create your own robot. So mark my words, it is a collaborative effort. You need passion, and it is only creativity of your mind which will take you somewhere. You can create anything in the world. It is your creativity and strength in your mind which will take you somewhere. Sky is the limit, as I say. Yeah? Thank you.
Good morning, all. I, Amol Lavate, feel honored and privileged to get an opportunity to thank Sir for enlightening us. On the behalf of Sri Balaji Society, I express my profound gratitude to our guest, Mr. Ketan Doshi, Sir, for sparing his valuable time to guide us for a successful career. We are greatly encouraged by your gracious presence and immensely benefited by your inspiring address, especially about inspiring Paypoint journey, team building, taking ownership, having patience, need of change, collaboration, and try to think different and think big. I would also like to thank our beloved Bala sir for his guidance and providing us such a stimulating and learning environment. Thank you.